What? We have a very special guest at the Washington Post today. It's Bill Nye, CEO of the Planetary Society.
Hi, Anna. Thanks for having me.
It has been a lifelong dream of mine to meet you.
Oh, it's so sweet.
Bill, I have always wondered, if you could go one place in the universe, where would you go?
The Earth is unusual. This is where I live. All my friends are from here. So if I could go anywhere to live, the Earth is it. But to explore and to visit, I would like to go to Mars, Europa, maybe Enceladus, the moon of Saturn, places that had or have water.
And why is water so important?
No, so water seems to be the key to life.
I wonder what it would be like to go on a trip with Bill Nye to the places in our solar system where there might be life.
So Anna, let us quickly, I would say even magically, go to three destinations in our own solar system where there might be something alive.
I can't wait.
Let me find the ingredients for life in a solar system. One, water, or another liquid solvent that chemicals can dissolve in. Two, certain elements like carbon and nitrogen. Three, an energy source like sunlight or chemicals from hydrothermal vents. And four, the perfect temperature, a place that's not too hot and not too cold. Oh, ingredients found. First stop, Mars.
When we look at the planet Mars, we can tell that it used to be covered with water. Well, you see the gullies where the water used to flow, these big basins where there used to be an ocean. And then in the last just few months, people realize that there's a giant pocket of water under the soil of Mars.
Liquid water.
Attention, explorers. More work needs to be done to confirm the presence of this lake, and radiation might make life here challenging. That said, I've detected methane in the Martian atmosphere.
The main way we know to make methane is with a living thing.
That's right. It's released in burps and farts.
So you're telling me that we could be detecting microbe farts on Mars right now?
Yes, absolutely. Are there Martian microbes, bacteria kind of guys and gals living in the Martian ocean thing?
That would be so cool.
It would be so cool. And if you're watching, it's very reasonable that you won't even be out of college before we discover this. Then when we go and look at Europa, which is a moon of Jupiter that you can see with a telescope.
The next stop is the icy moon Europa.
Under the ice is an ocean with twice as much water as the Earth. So if you have ocean water on Europa for 4.5 billion years, is there something alive there? Are there Europanian fish people swimming around talking Europanian? And just think if there are multicellular animals, or whatever you'd call them. I mean, their idea of the sky would be very different. It's covered with ice, right? Hello! Europanians!
Fishy friends!
Fishy Europanian friends!
Guys, if there are Europanians, I'm pretty sure they don't speak English, but I could translate.
So we've talked about Europa. We've talked about Mars. But you also mentioned one other moon, Enceladus.
Yes, is a moon of Saturn. And it's renowned because on the Cassini spacecraft, we found that there are geysers of water shooting into space.
Space geysers.
We're now approaching Enceladus.
Plumes of looks like water shooting into space.
Oh my gosh, it's so beautiful. But could there be little microbes shooting up from those?
Microbes of Enceladusians.
Excuse me, a warning. Please return to the ship. It's negative 261 degrees Fahrenheit. And frankly, I'm not sure how you're still alive.
I'm not appropriately dressed for Enceladus.
You might ask, as I might, if this thing is so cold, and it's covered with ice, how does the liquid water stay there? Why doesn't the whole thing freeze up?
Why doesn't it freeze up?
Because the gravity of these planets is so strong. How strong is it? That it squeezes the moons so that an ocean can exist under the ice.
Wow.
If you've never done this, try this. A clean rubber band.
Okay.
Take the rubber band and touch it to your lips. Then stretch it a few times. And then touch it to your lips again. You'll feel it's warm. So you've taken the energy of pulling this in and out, converted this energy of motion, this kinetic energy, into heat. Well, on Europa and Enceladus, the squeezing of the orbiting these enormous planets keeps liquid water under the ice. It's amazing.
Next stop, Earth. It's time to go home, everybody.
Just keep in mind, everybody, as we study these other worlds, we learn more about our own world. And by studying the climates, especially of Mars and Venus, we realize that the Earth is this so-called in-between world.
So we're in this very special place,
the specialist of places. And so this is why managing the Earth's climate is so important for us humans. The Earth's going to be here no matter what we do, people. We want to preserve the Earth for us, humans.
Well, Bill Nye, thank you so much for taking us on this tour of our solar system and all of the places where we might find life.
Thanks, you guys. Go out there and change the world.
Science magic show, science magic show, science magic show.